Hello, I'm Maruk Saeed, your microbiology guide. Let's explore in-depth micro techniques and uncover groundbreaking insight together on this educational journey into the fascinating realms of microbes.
Our DNA is like a library housed in the nucleus of our cells, containing hundreds of volumes. Some of these books, known as genes, are particularly significant since they contain the blueprints for all of the proteins present in the cell. On a molecular level, DNA is made up of two strands of nucleotides, and each gene is just a section of that nucleotide sequence. DNA nucleotides are composed of a sugar, deoxyribose, a phosphate, and one of the four nucleobases, adenine, cytosine, guanine, and thymine, abbreviated as A, C, G, T. To form double-stranded DNA, the nucleotides on one strand form hydrogen bonds with the nucleotides on the opposite strand. A binds with T and C bonds with G, thus the name complementary bases. Now, the objective of DNA is to store information, pass it on to daughter cells, and use this information to make proteins. This requires two crucial processes: DNA replication and gene expression. DNA replication happens during the cell cycle, especially the S phase of interphase. So the cell cycle consists of two stages: interphase, when the cell prepares for division, and mitosis, when the cell splits into two daughter cells. Interphase contains three subphases: G1, S, and G2. During the S subphase, the cell duplicates its DNA, ensuring that the two daughter cells get the identical DNA during mitosis. If we zoom in on double-stranded DNA, we can see that an enzyme known as DNA helicase separates the two DNA strands during replication. The single strands are then used as templates by another enzyme, DNA polymerase, which adds complementary nucleotides to them. Gene expression, on the other hand, is the process of decoding the information encoded in the DNA so that the cell may produce proteins. It involves transcription and translation. Transcription is the process by which RNA polymerase duplicates the gene's nucleotide sequence and produces a messenger RNA molecule, or mRNA, with one difference. Instead of thymine, it contains uracil nucleotides, or U. During translation, cell organelles called ribosomes read the mRNA molecule in three nucleotide words, known as codons, with each three nucleotide sequence coding for an amino acid that will eventually form part of the protein. To pass on or express unmodified genetic information, the DNA strands must be intact, or at least substantially intact, for the cell to operate. Unfortunately, the cell is constantly exposed to both endogenous and external environmental agents that might harm DNA. Fortunately, if DNA is degraded, the cell can enter a specific phase outside of the cell cycle called the G0 phase, in which DNA repair mechanisms attempt to repair the damage. If the DNA damage starts to pile up, a cell will typically go down one of three paths. First, the cell may enter senescence, which is when it stops dividing. Second, the cell may undergo apoptosis, or programmed cell death. Third, the cell may continue to divide uncontrollably, eventually becoming a tumor. None of these ways are perfect. Therefore, cells must repair reversible DNA damage and avoid excessive DNA mutations. In general, there can be either single or double strand damage, and the cell has mechanisms in place to deal with both. Single-strand damage can be caused by either endogenous reasons, such as faults in DNA replication, or external sources, such as damaging chemical or physical agents. Three repair processes address single-strand damage: mismatch repair, base excision repair, and nucleotide excision repair. During replication, DNA polymerase can occasionally insert the incorrect nucleotide, such as pairing adenine with cytosine instead of thymine. This is known as a mismatch, and it occurs around 60,000 times every replication, or one out of every 100,000 nucleotides. The first approach to correct a mismatch is immediately after it occurs, because DNA polymerase is a clever enzyme that can glance over its shoulder to check for faults and ensure that the correct nucleotide was used. It's similar to proofreading an essay for mistakes before submitting it. If DNA polymerase detects a mismatch, it returns and functions as an exonuclease, removing the incorrect nucleotide from the freshly manufactured DNA strand and replacing it with the correct nucleotide. This is known as proofreading, and while it still leaves some mismatches behind, it decreases the mistake rate to around 600 times each replication, or 1 out of every 10 million nucleotides. The next step is mismatch repair, which uses specific proteins known as MSH proteins to rectify any remaining errors after replication. When MSH proteins detect a mismatch in a newly manufactured strand, they summon an enzyme called endonuclease, which functions as a pair of scissors, severing the nucleotide links from the DNA strand. The damaged piece of DNA is then removed by another enzyme, known as exonuclease, creating a gap in the daughter strand. Then, DNA polymerase can come in and patch the gap with new nucleotides, similar to how you have to go back and rewrite a paragraph of your essay if your supervisor points out an error. Finally, once DNA polymerase has completed matching the correct nucleotides, another enzyme, DNA ligase, binds the links, and the damage is effectively repaired. However, even mismatch correction leaves a small amount of mistakes, 6 every cell cycle, or 1 out of every 1 billion nucleotides. Of course, nothing compares to the original 60,000. Base excision repair is used when the cell's DNA is damaged due to exposure to damaging chemicals or physical conditions. For example, compounds present in cured or pickled foods, such as nitrites and nitrosamines, can trigger demination, or the removal of an amino group, from nitrogen bases. This alters the molecular structure of the nitrogen base. Demination, for example, converts cytosine to uracil, guanine to xanthine, adenine to hypoxanthine, and 5-methylcytosine, cytosine with a methyl group attached, to thymine. So, nitrites may wreak havoc on DNA, much like a baby taking your computer and rearranging the letters in your paper. Base excision repair is based on glycosylase enzymes, which remove the damaged base and leave behind a small gap in the nucleotide known as an AP site, apyrinic or apyrimidinic. In other words, the nucleotide is reduced to its sugar and phosphate group, as there is no base present. The links between the phosphate, sugar, and other nucleotides are then severed by an enzyme known as AP endonuclease. Following that, an exonuclease eliminates them, causing a gap in the broken DNA strand. Finally, DNA polymerase fills the gap with new nucleotides, and DNA ligase seals the bonds. In contrast, nucleotide excision repair repairs DNA damage produced by physical agents such as damaging UV radiation. UV light produces pyrimidine dimers, which are often formed between two neighboring thymines on one of the DNA strands. These two thymines form bonds with one another, altering the DNA strand in that area of the molecule. So, nucleotide excision repair relies on endonucleases, which produce two incisions in the DNA strand, one on the 3 side of the damage and one on the 5 side, leaving a fragment of 12 to 24 nucleotides with free ends that are susceptible to exonucleases. Exonucleases then remove the nucleotides. Finally, DNA polymerase inserts new nucleotides, and DNA ligase seals the bonds once again. Finally, ionizing radiation, such as X-rays and gamma rays, can damage the phosphate backbones of both DNA strands. This generates double-strand breaks, the most severe form of DNA damage. In general, double-stranded DNA breaks are not clean, which means that either end of the broken DNA has a single-stranded area that overhangs the remainder of the double-stranded DNA. It's like when you break a pencil with your hands. The majority of the pencil stays intact, but the break is jagged. Now, there are 2 primary repair mechanisms for repairing double-strand breaks. The most prevalent type is non-homologous end joining, which involves a protein complex called DNA protein kinase attaching to both ends of the damaged DNA. Next, in order to trim off the single-stranded ends, it enlists the help of another protein known as Artemis, which is named after the Greek goddess. It is similar to smoothing the broken ends of a pencil with a little piece of sandpaper to make it easier to glue the pencil back together. Ultimately, the two ends of DNA are joined by a ligus enzyme, which functions as the glue. Since Artemis cuts off some nucleotides, non-homologous end joining is an error-prone repair that leads to a loss of genetic information. If you have watched till here, don't forget to subscribe to Family of Science Lovers. Press the bell icon button so you are always updated. Another repair method that depends on homologous recombination is known as homologous end joining. Our 46 chromosomes are organized into 23 pairs of two homologous chromosomes, which share nucleotide sequences and code for the same traits. Consequently, the sister chromatid may be used to fix a double strand break on one of the chromosomes. Initially, exonucleases that cut nucleotides from one strand of the DNA are brought in by a protein complex known as mRN, which attaches to both ends of the broken DNA. To make the process more clear, we can call the ends of the broken DNA end1 and end2. So now, end1 is placed near a similar nucleotide sequence called homologous sequence, because it's found in the same spot on the homologous sister chromatid. Afterwards, end1-inch forms a loop in the homologous DNA by pairing with the corresponding strand of the intact homologous DNA region. After then, a DNA polymerase adds nucleotides to end1-inch until it reaches a complementary sequence to end2. The homologous DNA is then released by end1, and its last nucleotides attach to the final nucleotides of end2. Finally, DNA polymerase fills the gaps on both sides of the union, and DNA ligase seals the bond. Since homologous recombination uses a sister chromatid as a template, this is a more reliable repair mechanism than non-homologous end joining because there's no loss of nucleotides. Okay, to quickly review, DNA repair systems aid in the prevention of senescence, apoptosis, uncontrolled cell proliferation, and tumor development in addition to preventing the accumulation of DNA damage. Repairing single-strand breaks in DNA can be accomplished through three methods: base excision repair, which corrects chemically induced demination damage; nucleotide excision repair, which corrects pyrimidine dimers caused by UV radiation; and mismatch repair, which corrects nucleotide mismatches that DNA polymerase failed to correct. Both homologous recombination and non-homologous end joining can repair double-strand DNA breaks. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon button. Thank you.